So the pan actually starts right here.
This pit was dug to show participants who came to the Fragipan Field Day at UK's Research and Education Center the average depth of the Fragipan beneath the topsoil. Typically 20 to 24 inches, the Fragipan is a cement-like layer that creates shallow soils with limited yield potential due to low water holding capacity. Soil scientists in the UK College of Agriculture, Food and Environment found that annual ryegrass broke down the Fragipan in laboratory, greenhouse and field studies the past 6 years.
We show the people that we have different ways to do it, but annual ryegrass is the best and best practical way we have right now, so we're concentrating on that. So we hope to show them this is something now ready for you to use.
A lot of people for many years have tried to do something, either with chemical amendments or with mechanical plowing, you know, through the Fragipan, and nothing really showed any promise. This was the first time that it was an eye-opening, really.
People attending the field day also learned about potential yield increase from annual ryegrass, ways to incorporate it and control it. Producers already growing annual ryegrass on their Fragipan soils, like Dave Fisher, an Indiana beef producer, says he's seen the results on his farm.
But at the same time, I had noticed that these fields seem to not dry out as fast, both as what they used to, but as well as I compare it to our neighbor fields. It just seemed like we were hanging in there a lot longer during drought periods.
Lloyd Murdoch says there are more than 50 million acres of Fragipan soils in the United States. And for him, who has been a soil scientist for more than 45 years, says it's some of the most exciting research he's ever been involved with.
Well, I wouldn't be interested in it if it didn't help people. That's number one. And number two is, when you do something that few or no other people have ever done before, it is really exciting. It's something that makes you want to wake up in the morning and go get your cup of coffee and take off to work.
From the University of Kentucky College of Agriculture, Food and Environment, I'm Jeff Franklin reporting.